Hey guys, welcome back to Killer 7. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Let's see if we can't finish up with the Sunset Chapter. Oh man, this is gonna be exciting. We shouldn't have too much left. I remember we have these posters. Yes, I remember you. Okay. Let's not get distracted again. Get my bearings here. It's actually been a few days since I've played. Okay, there's gonna be one coming in from the left. Is he actually moving? Do I hear footsteps? Okay, didn't mean to shoot there. I do not, so let's turn this corner real quick. Yeah, we're gonna need to get to the end of this hallway here. Yeah, you may recognize that. What was it, Phantom Smile? And there's the enlarged body part. Yeah, we need to shoot that hand. There we go, cool. We're already maxed out on blood, so we don't need to worry about that. What we need to do is take down this fucking smile and then get past these lasers. I'm gonna have to switch to Kevin here as soon as I take this guy down. All right, awesome, let's get moving quickly. Con, we don't have all the time in the world. If we accidentally trigger this trap, I think you can just walk back a few feet and then walk back through. It's really not a big deal. Alright, so we hit the Y button. Check this out. Take our sunglasses off, and there you go. We're totally invisible. We can walk through smiles. We can walk through traps. All sorts of good shit. It's pretty overpowered when you think about it, honestly. Alright, so what's going to be through this door? Ah, did I get all of the puzzles solved? I sincerely hope so. Let's just skip this. Yes, alright, awesome. Again, I mentioned it before, but in case you've forgotten, the dialogue is always the same on that guy, so I'm gonna start skipping it. And backflip! Oh my god, I need to learn how to do that up stairways, honestly. So, we're here. We're gonna have another mini-boss smile to fight. Hopefully, this one won't be too much of a problem. I guess we're about to find out. And where am I going today? Whoa, taking a right turn here. And Mr. Bloody Sunday, are you here? Ah, yes. Thank you. What do you got to say to me? With arms wide open, it holds a large circle. I'm not singing that. I do apologize sincerely. It's going to slice us to pieces. It turned around. Now! Now's your chance! So, there's a bright spot on it when it turns around. That one was actually extremely descriptive there, buddy. I do really appreciate that one. Good deal. So let's head into this hallway. Basically, we need to get him to turn around and then shoot a bright spot on him. Oh, the backside smile. We actually see a ton of these guys here in the future, so get used to them. Basically, you want to shoot the sickle. You want to shoot it again. You want to shoot it again. There he goes. And then hit the spot like so. It's easy with a character like Khan and something where you can just repeatedly dump bullets into the sickle and get them to turn around almost immediately. Ultimately, not a bad smile, but when you combine him with other smiles and you're trying to get him to turn around while other guys are going, you know, super fast at you, he can be pretty threatening in that regard, so you do need to be careful. And I do think that a grenade from Mask will still take them down in one hit, I'm pretty sure. I am sure that we will explore that more in the future here. What's going on, buddy? You don't say. Yeah, we're going after Jean here. I know, he's just a petty assassin. I'm really not sure why I'm, you know, sent to do this. Dirty tricks to pulverize him. Okay. Just do what I gotta do. In other words, traditional fighting on this guy is not going to work at all, so... Oh! Way to just spoil everything, it was Zaro. Yeah, we need to aim for the ceiling to take him down. We need to find an alternate way to take him down because we can't shoot him for some weird reason that's never explained. Elevator? We're actually going to go down to the basement first. Yeah. Check this out. Alrighty. Oh god, so we need to be masked here? Alright. I can definitely do that. Switch back to him. Oh, another really cool thing about cracked walls is that if you're exploring around with Khan, he'll actually like hear sound, or rather it's like wind or something coming from the cracks, so you can find hidden rooms with Khan if you're running around with his super hearing. It's pretty nice. Oh, I see the little prick job right there. Come on, let's do this.
We meet again, babyface.
So you were behind this after all. I guess my speech was meaningless.
Lucha Libre is for kids. But you know, you are great with the kids, Masked Man.
Children are pure. They know who's the strongest.
Ooh, I actually really like that quote. Alright, so, take him down. Aw, oh, come on, I gotta reload first. So cheap. I have a ton of health with masks, so it shouldn't be a big problem. Oh, fucking hell. I have always had a relatively difficult time with this boss, though, and I'm not sure why. Maybe because he's a cheap dickens. And apparently, you can actually... Ah, I can't aim quick enough. Apparently, you can actually use any character to shoot the wall down, which is interesting. I'm pretty sure I shot... Yeah, I got my grenade off, but it didn't count. But you can see, Mask just has so much health, so... It's more of an exercise of, like, trying not to get pissed off at this guy. Oh, that didn't hit him? Are you kidding me? Holy fuck. Maybe I should try a quicker character. I've never actually done this before. I've always used Mask. The Khan, it's gonna be a little risky, because he has a lot less health, obviously. But let's see if this will actually work. Again, never done it. Oh god, he's so short. Did I get it? I'm gonna run out of fucking ceiling here. Oh yeah, that worked just fine. Oh god. He just offed himself. That was awkward. Cool. So I'm learning things here as well, viewers. Very nice. With our target down, we're gonna head into the Mahjong room and get a little bit of exposition here.
Taking advantage of us, aren't you? There's more than one scenario, you know.
You got this all mixed up, you monkey. Don't you think you can hold on to the bar forever when you're on the verge of death?
Listen to him, barking like a stupid dog.
Gee. So, you finally reveal your true self. You dirtbag.
I'll take that as a threat to the States.
Pong.
It's the one who designs first that wins.
I didn't know monkeys could design.
Don't underestimate the monkeys!
Pong.
There are dogs bred for fighting, and they're mean sons of bitches.
How do I stop your barking?
Chi.
What?
What can one knight possibly do? Don't you care about winning?
You really are a stupid dog. You'd better pay attention before someone puts a bullet in your head.
Shut up, monkey. Ricci.
Too bad. Like I said, I know your train of thought. Lawn.
Bullshit! Enough of the caviling. This is pathetic.
Hey, yo! Cheater! That's a footy ten. You got no hand.
What?
Shit. It's all over.
So that happened. In case you weren't following that, and I'm trying to, but I do believe that, like, there were two U.S. representatives there and two Japanese representatives, and they were discussing whether or not that the fireworks are gonna go off. I think that's how that works. What the fuck? Khan, you hear Susie as well? Holy shit, you're amazing. I did not know that. Spoiler alert. Susie time. Hey, girl. How's it going? Talk to me. What's going on? Yeah. Yeah, I noticed. You're nice. You know, you're out and about. That's cool. I would agree with that. Well, you are a severed head, after all. This is kind of depressing. Wait, what are you talking about? Susie? Are you killing people again, girl? You meant him. Daddy Longlegs? Wait, what? Oh, yeah, I'll take that. Thank you. Alrighty, viewers. We recovered the Wind Ring. Awesome. Oh, how dare he? Yeah, no joke. Yeah, that's the first time you killed Susie. I'm just gonna close this. You freak me out sometimes. Okay, moving on. Let's go ahead and heal up Khan before I forget. Mask is wounded, but we're probably not gonna pull him out again. We're getting some, like, fucking Captain Planet shit going on. We got wind, water, fire. Alrighty, nice. We'll equip wind, why not? Oh, hey, Travis, what's going on, buddy? What does the shirt say? I can't see it. Do you kind of piece that together, viewers? Let's see the shirt real quick. I'm too fucking short. I think it says Spiral. But, Madsuken was the guy at that meeting earlier with the two older gentlemen. And Kunlan kind of possessed him? I'm not sure exactly what he did, but basically, he gave him some of his power, and I think he's actually in control of him. Which would mean that Kunlan is actually, in a way, control of Japan as well. It's kind of scary. So, I put that on the control panel there. We need to go back to the hallway, and in doing so, that actually enables the elevator to take us to a new area. So, off we go. Okay, any smiles? Yes. Good deal. Where are you, bastard? I don't like playing this game with headphones, I'm not gonna lie. There he is. The first time, or rather every time I played it, I haven't used headphones, so this is the first time. And it's super goddamn freaky, man. I'm not gonna lie. Look at all these smiles. This is incredible. Alright, Khan. Holy hell. You can tell I'm a little rusty, viewers. Fuck you. Fuck you. You're cool. And fuck you. Oh god, I missed him.
Fuck you.
And that one up on the ceiling there. Oh, DePaul. What are you doing up? Yeah, they are pretty damn cool. I never did watch wrestling growing up. Masty Smith. Is this your last wish, man? Oh, what? Uh-oh. But is that a bad thing? Huh. Matsuken, huh? I see you up there, you little shit. What do you think you're doing? You're not fooling anyone. I really want to be a bastard. I don't need the blood, so let me just see if I can't counterattack him, because he's just so fucking cool. Bam! Oh my god. Oh, that's amazing. Yo, this isn't a goddamn... Huh? You have a dream? Hmm. Yeah, that's a good way to make peace. Kill everyone who's against peace. Oh god, so crucial to beating that fight is listening to this fucking kid. I didn't really finish my train of thought there, but fucking everyone is lining up to greet me here. We had Susie and Travis and DePaul, Bloody Sunday. Is there anyone else? Seriously, guys. We're gonna head up to the roof. Oh, this boss fight. I hate this boss fight so much. Alright, buddy, what's going on? Jetpack dude. It's nice that I don't have to worry about blood. In fact, I'm so bad at this, I wonder if I shouldn't see if I can't find it. I think there's a Harmon's room around here somewhere. Oh, that's not good. Oh, this is good. I'm just gonna finish him gangsta style, apparently. The meeting room's right here. In order to get in here, you actually have to have the wind ring equipped. so you can blow this giant tarp off of the passageway here. Ah, fuck. I didn't realize that would send me in there. Well, that's not good. Well, here we go then.
This country is big. It's too big.
Our voices will never be heard.
You really think you're better than us because we're old men? You're not getting out of here alive. Japan's not going down just yet. Not without a fight. We'll show him, right, partner?
Okay. This is gonna get a little stressful, viewers. Oh, the music here is so good. But... well, there's no but. It's gonna be fucking stressful, I'm not gonna lie. They shoot out these projectiles, like so. Basically, like, little floating... I don't know, a bunch of flesh, something like that, and it's kind of freaky. We need to... shoot the guy with the tie and not get hit by these, obviously. And while one of them is distracted, we have to shoot them in the brain. It's a complicated thing. It'll make more sense when I actually do it. And we actually have to use Barefoot Lady here to do this. I don't know if it's actually possible with anyone else. This is why I leveled her up. Okay, so maybe I should get the projectiles first. Just shoot these here so I don't get tagged. Alright, good deal. And then, oh god, they're shooting more. Alright, tie. Tie. There we go. It doesn't damage him, but what it does is messes his tie-up, which causes him to come out, which exposes his brain, allowing you to get a shot off. Yeah, we gotta shoot those brains there. Let me reload, because it takes a fucking dog's age, and get this going here. Hopefully this fight will go well. I don't want to have to edit out anything, because it can take me a really long time, depending on how accurate I am. Oh shit, speaking of accuracy, god damn it, we're already botching this. Careful, does it? You don't have to shoot the projectiles. You can just kind of casually dodge them like so. Just wait for them. If you're feeling brave, it may be a little bit more safe to actually shoot them down, but sometimes I just like to dance around like a fool. Okay, where is your tie, man? Yeah, get your little chief here. Nice. How many shots does he... oh, shit. Two shots, huh? Maybe because I upgraded her damage? I don't know, actually. That was awesome, though. You can also, like, if you're just getting totally fucked, hide in a corner here, and they literally can't touch you. You know, obviously you can't hit them back, but... how do I hit you now? Because your tie won't do anything. He doesn't have anyone to fix it. Let's shoot... I think I have to shoot these projectiles down, right? And then... oh! Yeah, he, like, cowers. Oh, shit! Well, that's gonna hit me. Yeah, he cowers, which gives me a very small opportunity to get a shot off. And as you may have noticed, every time that I'm actually hitting these guys, they're shooting out more projectiles, so I have to be careful. Okay, line up the shot. And... nice! Good shot. Okay. We should be able to do this, then. I'm feeling pretty confident. Let's get the fuck out of the way. Oh my goodness, lady, that was embarrassing. I should probably heal, but... hopefully he can go down in two shots too. That would just be so fucking nice. You have no idea, viewers. Oh, I'm so happy. Wow, I was nervous about that, man. And there we go. The boss has been defeated. Seemed kind of ominous, though. Like, kind of a hollow victory, if you will. Where are we headed now? Out of the Kaku building. Never to return there again, hopefully. We're going all the way back to Washington State? Yep, yep, cool. Probably back to our trailer house, right? Let's see. Oh! Meeting up with Mills, no doubt, here at the overpass. Our typical meeting spot.
What can you do when the whole world has its eyes on you?
Almost everything. Destroying one or two nations? It's an easy task here. The promise made 30 years ago wasn't a guarantee. It was only the beginning of a countdown. Look at them. They're heading toward hell.
What's sad is that we've gotten used to this. I mean, our senses. That's pathetic.
That doesn't necessarily mean that we're not human.
Okay, now you're not helping.
Boom. There we go. Another chapter complete. A lot to take in this one. This is where the game starts getting pretty crazy, eh? A lot of weird shit to follow. Okay, it's gonna be, 82. 82 smiles. Oh god, I'm so off, aren't I? Oh, not too bad. Alright, fair enough. We almost got up to 100. God damn it. And a little quote to see us off. Okay, fair enough. Well, that about does it for today. Tomorrow, we're gonna be checking out Cloud Man. This chapter is fucking crazy. It actually is full of anime cutscenes, as well as just utter insanity. It's a lot less, what's the word? Doesn't talk near as much about the political shit. It's more just fucking craziness. I can't really describe it very well without spoiling things. Just be ready for it. It's gonna be a blast. And it has Cam Clark, you know, the dude who did Liquid Snake's voice. It's a very recognizable voice. Oh man, look at him. Kinda freaky. Well, as always, viewers, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you then. Have a good night.